This is the deluxe edition of Electric Ladyland. We've done a lot of albums with Jimmy in the past 10, 15 years that were records that showed where he might have gone, and collating all of them, putting it together, they make fantastic records, and they're interesting, and they're phenomenal in the sense that we get a window into what Jimmy could have done. But Electric Ladyland, it's a complete work. It's a complete body of work. Jimmy was inspired to do this album. A double album. Who would ever thought of a double album in 1968? Wow. This is the definitive album that Jimmy had created. Not only was it musically fantastic and challenging, but technologically, we just jumped into an area that nobody had even done before. Jimmy was in charge. He designed the album cover. The whole thing was his concept from beginning to end. From the moment that I arrived in America, which was April 17th, 1968, the next day I was in the studio, and there's Jimmy, and got a nice big welcome, and that was fantastic, and trying to get my feet wet and acquainted with what was going on with the console. There's a 12-track machine. My God, I'd never seen a 12. When I left England, we only had 4 tracks, and here's Jimmy with 12, and he would often say, man, 12 tracks, I think of all the guitars I can put on here. This is so cool. Okay, Jimmy, go for it. Walking into the record plant was, it just blew my mind because it was very primitive. The walls were these thin concrete walls, actually breeze block, concrete block walls, and a thin pane of glass. So if Jimmy was in the studio with his amps cranked, the glass would shake. It was hilarious. I think the most exciting thing was the fact that we're in New York, and New York had this vibe, and Jimmy was so happy here. He was just thrilled to be in the studio and creating this record that he was in charge of. For instance, 1983, which was an interesting song to mix, to say the least, it required probably a couple of hours of rehearsal, and it was Jimmy and I sitting together, four hands on the board. All right, Jimmy, you're going to do this part. Okay, great. I've got this part. And then there's a certain section here where we would switch. And that's when things got really funny, because it was a rehearsal, and we did many of those. It was a theatrical thing, because all of a sudden we had to kick the chairs from underneath us and literally go, switch. And I'd get to this side of the board, and Jimmy would be on that side of the board. And as this was going on, we're laughing our asses off and still trying to concentrate on doing what we're doing, because there's so much shit that's going on. Hands are flying everywhere. Get that? No, you get this. Okay, fine. And then we're back again. It was a dance. We've mixed all of Electric Ladyland 5.1 surround sound, every track. We've also included the original stereo mix in high resolution audio. It sounds brilliant. As he found all the tapes from his hotel room where he was doing the demos for the Electric Ladyland album, and they're beautiful. On one track there's Jimmy's voice, and on the other track is the guitar, and he's singing so quietly. In the box set, there is a really fine performance of Jimmy at the Hollywood Bowl. I've seen some of the pictures where the fans are going bonkers. There's a big pool in front of the stage, and they're jumping in this pool. And Jimmy's saying, no, man, no, man, don't get electrocuted, though. He was so scared for somebody in the audience to get electrocuted. The whole thing was so out of control. But it's the phenomenal live event where LA goes crazy for Jimi Hendrix. I think with all the hard work that we put in over the last 6 months or so, mixing this Electric Ladyland album in 5.1 surround, which was very tricky, trying to figure out all the complexities of duplicating what we had done 50 years ago, listening to it, and thinking, you know, modern technology just caught up with Jimi Hendrix.